So we were studying the communism. In that, first we have seen the first principle, dialectical materialism. Second is the materialistic interpretation of history. This is the second principle. According to the Karl Marx, the full history was formed because of material. So materialism is responsible for the existence of history. He explains the pre-stages of history that are also responsible because of materialism. Karl Marx speaks of the four stages through which production passes. Means he thinks that history was formed because of materialism, material things. So stages are primitive, ancient, feudal and capitalist stage. So in primitive community stage, in this stage the means of production are owned by the community and they are a measure. Means in this primitive community stage, the production is owned by the community and they are a measure. Measure means small in quantity, means only a small quantity of community only makes the production. Next is the ancient stages. This is the second stage. In this stage, owners of slaves and of the means of production get everything substantial, and the poor and the slaves who receive very little from the exploited a lot. Means in this stage, production is done and profit is gained, but very little portion of it is given to the slaves, workers, and they are exploited a lot. This is seen in the ancient stage. Third stage is of the feudal stage. Feudal means lord. In this stage, the feudal baron owns land, the most important means of production, and exploits the serf. Means in the third stage, feudal means lord, owns land. This is the important part of the production and exploits the serf. Serf means the servant. Fourth stage is of the capitalist stage. In this stage, capitalist owns all the important means of production and makes the workers, wage slaves, as a tools. Means here, capitalist owns all the important means of production. Economically, political, they are very strong. And they make the workers slaves as a tools. As a tools, they are using them. So material conditions of the life are so important that they determine the political and economic conditions. This is the second principle, materialistic interpretation of history. Third is the theory of surplus value. This system is the selfish system. Which surplus value? Because it favors only the capitalist class only. In this theory, he proved that the maximum profit is earned by the capitalist class and the minimum share and the profit is distributed among all the workers. Here he calculated the cost of product which was sold in the market and the wages, salary which was given to the labor, and there was a great difference. Means cost of product which was sold in market and the wages, salary given to the labor. Difference was vast, great difference was there. So here we can see that laborers are given a very small part of the production, means small part of the salary. This is known as surplus value according to the Karl Marx. So here majority of the class is away from political freedom, political power, political freedom, economical power, economical freedom. This theory of surplus value. Next is the theory of class war. So in this theory of the class war, there are two classes. Class war means two classes. And there is always a war. One is the rich and poor, one is exploiter class, another is exploited, one is administrator, another is subject, one is landlord, another is the landless or a labor class, one is a capitalist and another is a labor class. And there is always dispute between these classes. Means from these classes we can see many classes in our society. But according to the Karl Marx, there is always war between this, dispute between these two classes. Next is the dictatorship of the proletariate class. Karl Marx wanted that the proletariate class, labor class, to establish their own class, power and dictatorship and to throw the capitalist class out of the society. In this class, there is nothing private. Everything belongs to the every citizen of the state. All the rights, powers are only concentrated in the labor class only. Labor class will hold all the political power, economical power independently in that state. So this is the dictatorship of the proletariat class. Means here Karl Marx wanted only the power in the hands of labor class. And the sixth point is the withering